Anybody else got a question? Or shall I just get up and start singing and dancing?
Singing and dancing.
That's all you want. Oh no, we've got one. Thank the Lord. I just saved you all from my singing and dancing.
So what? How did you get the job on Assassin's Creed? Tell us about how the experience was.
Getting the job. Finally! Yeah, usually about 5 minutes late. That's your usual, right?
Welcome, Victoria. Welcome back.
Hi.
We have Victoria Atkin and Paul Amos.
Oh, she got a round of applause. I got nothing. I was here holding down the fort, you know, with people that don't even know who I am in the back, who are now on the phone. Get off the phone! Or get out! I don't care if it's taped to the side or not. Out! Gee whiz, unbelievable.
Sorry.
What? No manners in Sacramento. No manners with the weather, anyway.
Yeah, right.
Oh, late. Late, I see.
We were just outside.
Yeah, you're our handlers. And late.
Hello, everyone.
Oh, yeah.
Hello.
Ooh, you're having a 7-up.
It's very rare for me to have a 7-up, but I am happy with it.
You're just the last day of the con, going a bit sugary.
Need a little sugar.
A little bit of sugar.
To compete with his energy. Or come anywhere close to it.
Okay, we got asked a question, how we got the job. So I could go on for like 15 minutes.
Yeah, or you don't want him to answer that.
No.
I don't anyway, because I've heard it a billion times. I could actually tell it.
Yeah, you could. Why don't you tell everybody how I got the job, and then I'll tell everyone how you got the job.
That's a fact.
And I swear to God, his will still be longer. And mine won't be. Paul got the job by... Now, let me see how accurate this is.
This is a challenge.
I might, I might just make some more shit up. Paul did so many flights. It was like the worst thing ever. He had to travel across the whole wide world to get this job. He was on holiday in Mexico and got a phone call. And then had to fly to, I'm going to make this up. I'm sure you'll correct me if it's wrong. To Toronto, then back to London, then to LA.
This is a terrible story. Everyone's like falling asleep. Usually everyone's like on the, they're just like, what happened next, Paul? And then what happened?
No, they're not.
Oh no.
That's just you.
Oh,
like getting excited over your own story.
Yeah, well.
Everyone else is like, we went to your panel before we heard this.
Yeah, exactly. Who went to the panel on Friday? See, I could tell this story and people would be entertained.
You can tell it, I just drink my 7-up.
How did you? All right. Usually how you got the job comes in on it anyway. All right, I'm going to be narcissistic and I'm going to tell the story.
That's rare.
What? You're going to have a narcissistic panel of shame.
He's never narcissistic. It's very rare.
Okay, so I'll tell the story, how I got the job. How I got the job was like this. I've always wanted to play video games. I've always played video games, even when I had a ZX Spectrum, and I had the tapes, and they, remember when they made those really funny...
No one is that old in this room.
Do you not remember that? And then you had to turn the tape over to load it as well. And God forbid, like, something went wrong in between, and you'd have to start all over again just to get the game on, right? Yeah, so anyway, I'm legit, I know. And then I had a PlayStation, Mega Drive first, then PlayStation 1, 2, 3. And then I had a kid, then I had to get rid of my PlayStation 3. And then I was finishing my job, Law School, and I really wanted to do a video game. Because I wanted to play myself, right? With myself. More frequently than I already was.
Family show.
This isn't narcissistic, obviously.
So I asked my agent, I was like, can you please go out and try and get me a job in the video game industry? So they came back and they were like, okay, we've got this thing called a TGF, which is like a pilot for video games. So I did it, and it was all coded, right? And it was called Albert. You know, I'm like, Albert? Who wants to be in a game called Albert? I mean, the only thing I could think of with Albert is a Prince Albert, and that's certainly not a video game that I want to be in.
We'll make it family friendly and go Fat Albert.
That's family friendly? Whoa.
Well, you know that does reflect the Victorian period, though.
Yeah, I know that.
Of course. So then it was about him.
So then I got on the set, and I was like, I saw these like things that mentioned Templars and Assassins, and I was like, oh my word, this is a pilot for Assassin's Creed, right? So, of course, my excitement went through the roof. I did the job, we finished it, And I thought, oh my word, I'm going to be in Assassin's Creed, like, if this goes. And if it goes off to Paris and they like it. So it went off and nothing happened for about 3 months and I didn't hear anything. And then I got a call from the director, who was a new director, because they changed the creative team. And he was like, we're just going to ask you to come in and do just a couple of voices on it. We had somebody else come in and do all the motion capture. And I was like, oh, all right, so I'm not going to be in the game. So anyway, they got greenlit. And then in the summer, they started casting for this show. And I'm like, okay, well, at least I'm going to get seen for the assassin, right? No, they send me in for, like, citizen number 3. And I'm like, oh, all right, okay. And then I didn't hear anything from that. So I thought, oh, my God, I'm not even good enough for citizen number 3. So I finished up a show I was doing called Lost Girl. And just as I was coming to the end of it, I got a call, 9 p.m. at night, which you don't usually get.
Oh, man, the story's only just started. This is
That's great, but look at them. They want to know, right?
Seriously, this has got another 20
Listen,
minutes.
Listen, you get the sit in your ass.
I thought we were halfway through, and then I realized
I'll
where we are
you,
in the story.
I'll tell you when you're needed, all right? You come in at the bit of the story where you get a laugh, right? Yeah, you get one laugh.
Can we just skip to that? Can we please skip to that?
No, I'm not skipping. I'm saying the whole story.
So
anyway, I get this call, and they asked me to come in and do like 15 pages the next morning. So I go in, I do it. I do an amazing job, clearly. And I don't hear anything. And I'm like, well, I didn't obviously get the job on like the fifth time. And then I'm in holiday in Mexico. I finished the show I'm doing. We're like 3 flights deep in Mexico.
Loomer, you need to turn the video off. This is just, you already got this.
Yeah, you can stop. You can edit.
I think it's longer than
some of these people. So anyway, I'm in Mexico, right? With my family. And I get a call. And it's from Ubisoft. And they're like, yeah, actually we did quite like you. Any chance you can fly to London, UK, tomorrow? And I'm like, I guess I could. So then I pack up our holiday, my daughter, my wife, myself. We fly all the way back to Toronto, 3 flights. And then I get on the plane the next day. I fly to the London, UK, and I go into the audition room. At this point, you think, oh my God, they're like flying me to the UK, right? I've probably got the job. And I walk into the room, and there's just loads of guys. And I'm like, oh my word, like, really? So I do my 20-minute audition, and I'm like, oh, maybe I haven't got the job. So I get on the plane, I fly back to Toronto. The next morning, I get a call, and they're like, hey, listen, they still like you, but they're wondering if you could fly to LA in 2 hours' time. And I'm like, well, I'm in Toronto in 2 hours, I've got to pick up my daughter. No, no, you need to get on the plane in 2 hours. So I get on the plane, 2 hours, I fly 5 hours over to LA. I get in at midnight, I get up the next morning, which is where she comes into the story, and I go to do an audition. At like 9:30, and I think, okay, they fly me to LA. Probably, I'm definitely the guy for the job right now. I'm the man, right? I walk in, and no, there's another guy waiting. And I'm like, and there's Victoria Atkin, who I meet for the first time. Who, incidentally...
So romantic. It was such a lovely experience.
She
really was rooting for the other guy.
She isn't moved. So why don't you tell everybody how you got the job, because you hadn't done anything up until this point.
Oh, no, I had done something. I walked from my guest house to the garage and put the tape, did a video, and sent it to Ubisoft.
And then they asked her to do this audition with me, where they could have flown her to Toronto, but she was like, nah, I'd prefer to do it in LA.
No, I just said, oh, I don't think I want to fly there.
So now I'm on like my 9th flight, right, in a week.
I did go to Quebec for, to meet the producers after I'd basically got the role.
So anyway, I do this audition, I'm like, oh, maybe I have got the job, I've got the job. I turn around, I go back to Toronto, 5 hours, and then I have to go and do a con in Winnipeg the next morning, because you can't get to Winnipeg unless you fly back to Toronto. So I get on another flight, and then I have to get back to Toronto on that Sunday evening, and then I wake up Monday morning.
A couple of people yawning.
And I've got the email that says, you've got the job. 10 flights in 1 week. That's what I had to do to get the job. I started that in 2015.
This is why you play more as Evie than Jacob. Because this is how you go around all the houses and do the missions wrong until you get the thing.
Oh, like everyone was soothed by my voice. Anyway, that's how I got the job. I answered the question. There you go.
You wish you never asked it, then.
Yeah.
I do wish you never
asked it. In future, never ask me that question.
No one asked that question
never
ever again.
Never ask me that question ever again, because I always tell the story.
You can ask me as a quick answer.
Yeah, because I can actually tell a story.
I have no story to tell. I just got the job like that.
Hang on a minute. I think I've got your book on audiobook, where you read London Love. Hang on a minute. That would be fun to listen to right now.
No, it wouldn't, Paul.
Hey, you got it queued up, mate.
Shut up. But we do have something that we want to give away. So we need some more questions so we can give you a signed...
best question of the day.
Fry Fight Club that we've signed for somebody today.
Get a signed t-shirt.
So,
whoever has it. See, now you're coming to ask
now
questions.
Now we need questions.
See?
This is the prize for the best question.
There you go. Basement. All right. Hello, Jacob. How are you?
I'm wonderful. How are you?
No, I'm not too bad.
Where are you from?
I am from LA.
Oh.
Yeah.
You sound like you have an English accent. Were you just putting that on?
No. It happens sometimes.
Because we're
talking...
I'll
be American now.
Okay.
Oh, well. Yeah, actually, I thought you were Northern.
Oh,
yeah, I thought you were from up north.
Sorry.
You were like, hello, Jacob.
From near Manchester.
I watch a lot of BBC.
Oh. You watch a lot of BBC?
You've been watching Peaky Blinders.
Or Game of Thrones. You're like Jon Snow.
That's actually how I did my first Assassin's Creed audition. They wanted Evie to be like Ygritte from Game of Thrones.
Oh.
So my first audition was in a Northern accent.
So you did a like Northern accent?
Yeah, I talked like that. Evie was going to talk like that.
Funny enough.
That would not have been attractive, I don't think.
My first audition was like that too.
We're not going to call that gang the Rooks. I don't think that would have been as good.
What's wrong with the Rooks?
You know nothing.
I love my Rooks.
I'm glad that we didn't have to speak like this.
No,
for
I like
six months.
My Rooks and a cup of tea.
Yeah. Cup of anyway,
chair.
What's your question?
Oh, sorry.
It's okay. I wanted to know what both of your favourite parts of the game were.
Ooh, what's our favourite parts of the game? When I have to do individual missions without him. I'm joking. I like the collecting the flower sequence. With Henry.
I hate that one.
And Paul hates it.
Is that the pressed flowers?
He gets
one?
No attention.
Oh, the pressed flowers. People hate the pressed flowers.
And we got extra money because he wasn't in those scenes.
I did a lot more days than you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Apart from the DLC.
Just.
But I liked the Alexander Graham Bell stuff as well. That was fun.
Yeah. I like the whole first sequence when it's just Jacob and it's really fun and they spent the most money on that sequence because it was really fun with the train crashing and all of that and it starts the game off in style. Yeah, that's my favorite sequence. And you haven't even, you're not even introduced to Evie at that point in time.
Yes, I jumped on the train with you.
Oh, yeah.
That's like how they introduced them.
Well, at the
twins.
Very beginning, but you're not in the level, right? You don't do anything in it.
That's right, I just do the cool bit at the beginning.
It's the next one. Next one's boring.
You're sneaky.
Good question. Thank you.
It's so boring. You just want to kick the shit out of everyone, don't you? Is that what you want to do?
Hey, how you doing?
Hi.
Stop everyone.
So I changed my look, so I just wanted
to... Yeah,
you have changed your look.
It's a cool leather jacket.
Very cool, very biker. Yeah.
Still like recognize me, right?
Yeah, you were down front of the other Q&A, dressed up as Jacob Fry. And we had our pictures taken with you as well.
Okay.
Yeah.
And the cane sword.
Yeah, the cane sword.
We remember. we don't forget an assassin face.
Yeah. Oh, it's a Paolo. Paolo?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, see? Wow, you remember the name. That's really good.
Nice.
Yeah, I'm one of the nice ones.
I'm not nice because I don't remember names. A billion names a day.
A lot of these stars couldn't give a shit about people, right?
Oh, of course.
They're just in it for the money.
Yeah.
I mean, look at Stan Lee.
What's your question?
How much more money does he need? He's a thief now.
Paul,
Stan Lee is a thief. He's thieving from you all.
Oh my goodness. What's the question?
So I came here because, you know, since today is the last day of SacAnime, which means it's also the last day of seeing you guys here.
I know, that's sad, right?
And
Don't cry, man.
No, I'm okay.
Do you need a hug?
No, I'm okay.
Are you okay? Okay, just checking.
No, it's just, all I can say is thank you for your time being here the past few days.
You're welcome, man.
Thank you so much.
Made my... You know, day very special yesterday, so it was my birthday.
High fives to that. We like that. Thank you. Thank you so much. That means a lot.
Which leads you to the question?
Well, my last main question to the end. If you guys have to watch The Walking Dead, do you watch The Walking Dead?
Yeah.
Well, we hung out with a guy from The Walking Dead last night.
You hung out with Kari?
Yeah,
Kari's awesome.
Yeah, well, us three
went out. He's really cool.
On Instagram, there's a little Instagram story of us three last night, which is fun.
It's Curry and Tesla's.
Yeah.
So like you guys know what's going on, right? In The Walking Dead?
I don't.
Do you know what? I tuned out of it. To be honest, I don't know how many. It's the same thing every season. We're in another compound.
We got another big bad to kill. Oh, Rick's losing his mind still.
That's pretty much the show right there, yeah.
It's like, oh. Sorry. I just don't watch it anymore. I told Carrie that too. Sorry, mate. I'm not going to watch
it. Hey, how you doing?
Hey. So, I'll ask you at the panel, but have you actually played Syndicate yourself? And if you have, is there
I'm just
going to
get on the table.
Tell me
I hate that question too.
Why don't you tell the story then?
No, I don't want to. I can't do it as well as you. I just don't have the personality.
You've given up.
To do it. No, I just...
Given up. You just know that I'm better than you.
Even with a 7-up, I can't compete. I think even if I have 50 Red Bulls here, I can compete.
Something about flying, right?
It's something about flying, yeah. Who was at the panel on Friday?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Well, I'll condense.
No, I thought it was great. I mean, watching Paul run around the room flapping his arms and prancing
this one.
Was hilarious.
This will be shorter than
do a run around the room for everyone. No, it always entertains
I've
me.
I've got to get to it.
Oh, sorry.
I've got to build up to it, right?
Sorry.
So...
Yeah, otherwise it just looks weird.
Okay, right. So we filmed...
It looks weird anyway.
In case you don't know, we motion captured this game, which meant that we filmed it like a movie for 4 months, right? So it's all of us, we get into gear, and we did things like when we were rehearsing, we actually had costumes made up of the characters so we could get into the characters. So we did a lot of character research, spent like a whole week trying to get into them.
Yep.
So we were really trying to get into these assassins, right? Trying to figure out how they are and stuff. So towards the end of it, they ask us to play the game. But it's not the game that you played. It's the shitty broken game that it's being
built.
Well,
it's not finished yet.
It's not finished. So the thing is, we would have to do this every weekend on top of filming. Remember, it was like we were working straight for about two or three weeks. And it was quite grueling. And we'd be in there for like 9 days playing the game, the broken game. So, you would be running around as Jacob more than Evie usually. And you'd be
they hadn't built the best part of the game yet.
All of a sudden, you'd hit a spot, and then it'd sort of glitch. And then it would do this. And then the guy would come in who's building it and control it, and it just starts taking over the build. Now, I've been working as an assassin, right? Trying to be really geese and really manly. And then he's doing this.
There's nothing manly about you.
Just flying to balls. And then carry on doing this. So, did I play the game?
Yes. That's how we played the game.
Did I enjoy playing it? No.
And sometimes Evie and Jacob would be merged into one person. It would be like Jacob head and Evie body.
Just, you know, kissing at the end. It just got all weird,
yeah,
right?
And
incestuous.
They, like, joined together. It was very, very odd.
Very
for
incestuous.
Us. But we did get to add improv lines for that. That was the reason why we were doing that.
Oh, yeah.
So the Jacob's cooking lines
that
were
was mine, yeah.
all added in for that. That was a long, long period of time for us. I think that was one of the hardest pieces of work.
I'd rather
have been on the mocap floor.
Playing the game for us was probably like the hardest and least satisfying, sadly.
I just remember the sandwiches that we ate. I don't remember much else about that. They were good.
Just the great lunches we had.
We'll get into lunch was like, it wasn't even, we were so exhausted. I had more energy doing the motion capture running around than playing this game where you're just...
And we basically had beanbags, right? And we'd be lying there.
Yeah, it was it was kind of the easiest paid job I've ever done, but it was still mentally exhausting.
I'd occasionally fall asleep on you.
Yeah. Not on me. We didn't
lie on each other
playing this game.
Like the bags would be close, but not too close.
We definitely had distance.
The beatbacks, that is, right?
Now we're like making it into something. It's like now it's like, what did you do? Nothing happened.
No sacks involved.
Okay, two more. What's your question? Oh man, this is so wrong.
I got food on mine because I missed lunch, so.
I haven't had anything to eat either, so no one
get
me something.
Then. If you could materialize any food, any meal right now, what would it be?
Well, I do have a penchant for burgers.
We had pizza yesterday.
But I really like deep fried chicken too, if it's done properly.
I just had my mom make me a roast dinner. Any excuse to have that.
I know, to be honest, I might actually agree for the first time with Victoria on that one.
Yeah, did you hear that? Get that one.
You've had a month.
A roast beef dinner, too.
Roast dinner. Well, in England, I don't think it's as prevalent here. It's a bit like a Thanksgiving dinner.
And it's every Sunday.
But we have it every Sunday. Roast potatoes, roast parsnips, meat.
And like a nice the roast of
oh,
beef
it's the best.
Or lamb.
But the way your mum makes it, I think it's only because your mum makes it and you're used to it. I don't think it's actually the best roast dinners, but because you're used to it, it feels like the best roast dinner.
Oh, we used to do, like, even when I was in drama, like I was in drama school and I was living with other actors, we would do it every Sunday.
Oh yeah, every time I lived in, I miss that. That's one thing I really miss in
and
LA.
The, it's just it's not, it's not, I try and implement it with my family, but it's not the same here. It's like, because there's usually a lot of people around. It's like a mini Thanksgiving
every Sunday.
Sunday.
It's a real like chance for a family to get together and sit around the table and talk about the week.
It's a shame. But
that's what I would have. Good question.
Yeah, so I agree with her.
Oh, now you're making me really hungry.
And it's Sunday, right?
Oh, we should be having a Sunday roast.
Is there anywhere that does a Sunday roast in Sacramento?
I wish my mum did Uber Eats.
Hello.
Hi.
Hello. My question is, what aspect of your characters do you admire the most about them?
About our own characters or about the other person's?
Your own characters. Okay. Or the other person's, either one.
What do I admire about Evie?
I admire Jacob's
drinking ability.
Yeah, drinking ability. It's just the whatever goes. Well, you know, it's just as long as it's fun. It's like a joie de vivre, right? You know, it's just let's just do it and have some fun. And you know, we try to push that more in the game. So because it's a game, right? You want to have some fun. So if you want to go and kick the shit out of everything and have some fun, that's what Jacob's there for. If you want to be all stealthy and I've stabbed you.
And have a more interesting game.
Yeah. Then you do that. Yeah. You'd have a more interesting game.
Oh, that sounds like the same.
I don't
having
do
fun
stealth.
Every...
How many people do stealth? How many people stab the shit out of everything?
But all those people that told me they played more as Evie, they're lying.
Yeah, of course they are. They're just being nice to you.
I admire Evie's kind of care for the community. Like, every mission she has, not only wants to complete the mission, but has this overall care for, like, Clara and Alexander Graham, but, and kind of takes...
Everyone except Jacob.
Yeah, but she does care for Jacob. Like, at the end when we have a sequence saying that we missed each other and all that stuff, she has a big... care, which I admire. She cares a lot about the other characters, which I think is a nice thing.
Thank you.
Thank
You're
you.
Very welcome.
Hello.
Hi.
Hello.
So my question is, I know...
you were dressed as Evie, weren't you?
Yes, she was dressed as Evie yesterday.
I have the jacket right now.
Oh, okay.
What jacket's that?
Evie's. It's by Ubisoft.
Wow, I haven't even seen that. Let's have a little twirl.
Nice. Does Jacob have one of those?
Yep, I have that one too.
Where?
Can I see the back? Can you just...
Cool. She just didn't want to take it off and give it to her.
No, I'm all right. She looks cooler in it.
Yeah.
So my question is, I know in Lost Girls, Beck's character wears high heels.
Yes.
So I was wondering if, I know one of the Templars, Roth, is kind of the gay Templar.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think Jacob would wear high heels and kick the shit out of Roth?
Well, I think there was a little love story with Jacob and Roth, wasn't there?
Well, I think Roth was very much in love with Jacob, right? And Jacob needed a father figure. So it's like he's a surrogate father figure for him, right? But then that relationship then became very, very complicated.
Mm.
That's how we played the sequence. And I think just Jacob's sort of joy for life, and then he met somebody who was offering exactly what he wanted, right? He just doesn't want to take it. He had no responsibilities. They were just going out. They would do raiding. They were drinking, doing everything, and just kind of got lost a little bit in that chaos. And, you know, maybe if Jacob got a bit lost in the chaos of that, he got lost in the chaos of decisions that he was making, so sexual or otherwise. And I think that after that sequence, actually, is the point where Jacob... sort of, he comes back, and if I don't know if you know the bit where they argue, and then they go their own ways. It's in sequence in the way we did the story arc. That's what happened. Jacob came back from that, and he's gone off into complete chaos, right? And he's just realized that he's gone too far, and that he's almost killing kids. He's almost going to blow up this factory. and like he's just gone way too far, and then he's killed Roth, and then he's had a, you know, he's kissed this guy, and then he goes back with his sister, and then she's on his case, and then he's had enough of everything, and then they split their own ways, and yeah, that's how that arc worked. Yeah, so would he wear high heels? Maybe when they were really, you know, drunk and high. Yeah.
Makes sense.
yeah, because obviously we, well, that's what we did.
Just still,
we
still
kind of played Roth. Roth was supposed to be played as like a bit of a, like he was high on drugs all the time. Like, because he's really manic, right? Roth is really super manic. And coincidentally, John Hopkins, who plays Roth, who did the voice, but he didn't do the motion capture, was my former housemate for 5 years.
Oh, wow.
And it was really weird, because I was like, I kind of know that. And I was like, oh my God, it's John.
Oh,
so we
good.
Worked together without even knowing. But yeah, I don't know. I mean, it's not, I don't think he's in Vex's realm, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, Jacob's in a slightly different realm. Yeah, but thanks
great
for
question.
That.
Yeah.
Great question. Oh, you finally thought of a question.
Yeah, well, you can't catch some people off guard. It's kind of like...
You can take the microphone down.
Oh, yeah, good, because I'm super short, but I have to take this out.
You can do whatever
there
you want.
There you go.
Okay, so I know it's been kind of stated that you didn't enjoy your gameplay all too much, but I still have some curiosities, just because everybody plays in their own way, and I was wondering, what compulsion do you have to your gameplay? Like, I know somebody who plays Grand Theft Auto, and anytime you see somebody smoking a cigarette within 15 feet of an entry, he knocks them out, because like he thinks it's rude, or like different compulsions like that. So what is your compulsion when you play games like that?
So
that's interesting
for me,
Victoria, because she just doesn't care about video games.
Oh, that's not true. I've begun to love video games. I just am a little bit of a bookworm, so I read a lot.
Yeah.
I don't know. I mean, I don't know. That's a tricky question for me. Paul, you should definitely answer that.
You know, I was more of a first person shooter myself. I played a lot of, I played all the Call of Duties, so that was where I was more inclined to play, as opposed to like sandbox games. And some Labyrinth games I liked. But yeah, I would like to just shoot the shit out of everything. And even civilians, if they were getting in my way.
So like anything goes down?
Anything, well, if it's bothering me, right? If like you're kind of getting in the way, like you shouldn't be there. I'm trying to shoot these terrorists right here. Can you just, I'm just gonna shoot you. I know I'm gonna lose 50 plus points, but it doesn't matter. I feel satisfied right now. And it's basically, it's about satisfaction, right?
Yeah.
That's all you're looking for when you play video games. Yeah. A release for the daily grind. Yeah.
Cool. And cool cosplay.
Thank you.
Isn't it? And she's
cool.
Got a lot of tape going on here as well.
Oh.
He just wears his clothes like off his shoulders. So.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And it's good. Good job.
There's commitment there.
Yeah, I like it.
Yeah.
Okay, great.
Thank you.
Cool.
Good.
Thank you very much. Yeah, you guys. Awesome. Thanks for the question.
Hey.
Finally. Oh, you bought one of those.
I think you might. Did you get that? That was like the last one.
Yes. Yeah. I'm jank on 7-inch
gear. Glitch gear. Glitch gear. We like glitch gear.
It's.
Wow.
Whoa.
Did you make that?
Indeed.
Good job.
Have we met you already this weekend?
Yeah, I'm not. Didn't meet Friday once.
You didn't come to get a signature from us? What kind of Assassin's Creed fan are you?
Awful.
Awful.
I hope you've got a
good
question.
Oh, now you think you're going to win the t-shirt, right?
You shouldn't have admitted that.
Think again.
But I do like the... Is it like a Deadpool Assassin's Creed?
Yep.
Yeah, that's cool. We went out with Nolan last night. That was fun.
Yeah. Yeah. It works. All right, what's your question?
So my question was, what was your favorite... Templar assassination sequence that you did, like which Templar did you and your characters enjoy killing the most?
Well, we did a double kill on Staric.
Yeah,
that
wasn't
cool.
It.
But it wasn't.
I had so many. How many did you have? Like 4 or 5?
I didn't have that many.
No.
Lucy, what's her face? Thorn.
Yeah.
She was fun to kill.
I really liked the one in the art gallery. Because that was a really fun sequence, and I remember when we were filming that one, and I was behind the big picture, the big painting, and then he rips through the painting and then just comes right out and stabs him. I like that one, and I like the cadaver one, when he's the dead body and then he just comes up. Yeah, that was fun. That was a fun sequence, both of those. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So there you go, that's mine.
Yeah, mine. I think Lucy Thorne.
Lucy Thorne,
like,
that was the big one, when you have a big fight, isn't it?
Yeah, we have a big fight up in the tower. Yeah, that was fun.
Yeah.
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 Thank you.
There you go. Thank you. That still wasn't good enough to win the t-shirt. I'm sorry. Yeah.
I think the t-shirt one's going to be one that we're still thinking about.
But if you really like, yeah, I might sign that if you want.
Do you need a wee or something? Why are you shaking the table?
I always shake.
Much?
It's because I have excess energy.
Can you stop?
Do you want some of my energy?
No. Yeah. I don't know how you're offering it. Whatever way you're offering it, no.
Hey. Sorry. Hi.
Hi.
Nice to meet you guys.
And your name is?
Brandon.
And you're from?
Sacramento,
California. And what do you do for a living?
Welcome.
No, you haven't got the job.
Thanks.
Also, my question is,
if you guys have seen the Assassin's Creed movie, what did you think of it?
No, I haven't.
We haven't.
And the 18% on Rotten Tomatoes is putting me off.
But apparently people have seen it. I went to the premiere, but I didn't see it because I had to fly back to shoot my new show. So I didn't get to see that. But
she's working.
I'm working.
Yeah.
You should tell them about my new show.
Oh yeah, she's got a wonderful new show that's going to be on. I forget the channel it's on because I don't have it. I doubt whether many of you do either.
What, but Netflix?
Yeah, no, it's going to be on Netflix. It's a great show. It's written by the same guy that did Ender's Game. Anybody know Ender's Game? Yeah, so yeah. There you go. He's part of it. It's a sci-fi thing where, you know, the world is almost extinct and then they come back down and they're back on planet Earth and fun and games ensue. Like musicals.
No, it's like just sold it and then like ruined it.
Exactly. And there's no musicals. They close off and it's kind of soft-born.
No, there's no soft-born. There's no soft-born in it. No one takes their clothes off, but it is set 400 years in the future.
Yeah.
And drones are running the Earth.
No, I was on the soft porn show. That was Lost Girl. That was 6 years of soft porn. It literally was.
So, unfortunately, yeah, we can't really comment on the movie.
I think it should have been a series. I really think it should have been a series. I don't think you condense the universe of Assassin's Creed into an hour and a half. And I think that's probably what people are having. If they're not fans or aware of the universe and they go and watch that movie, from what I hear, it's really difficult and the concept just sounds a bit ridiculous.
I'm looking forward to seeing it though. I do want to watch it.
Yeah.
I do think if you know the Assassin's Creed world, it will be worth watching.
Yeah. But, you know, I think there's a huge potential for the Assassin's Creed world to go into something, whether it's TV, film.
I would love to see Jacob and Evie animated for a Netflix animated series.
Yeah.
I think that would be really fun.
I think, especially because they did the comic book.
Yeah.
I think it'd be a nice progression to go into some animation with them. And then they could really, you know, they could use a lot of the concept stuff that they've already got in place.
Yeah.
Could be fun. Who would watch an Assassin's Creed cartoon?
Yeah, see? Well, this is anime Loomer. Convention, of course they would.
that was everyone in the room.
Loomer, everyone. You need to picture so you
And saw. Who would watch a cartoon with Jacob and Evie?
Oh, everyone.
Everyone in the room.
Yeah, this is fun.
You'd be
Set
soft.
In London as well. It would be good. You'd be able to see so much stuff.
Yeah.
It would be great. Thank you for your question.
Lovely, thank you.
And you.
Hey,
what's happening?
On? What are you doing? Yeah. Lost?
Lost and found is the office is right here.
all the stuff people wanted to leave in the room.
Lost and found security offices right there under the table.
Do you want to come and have a cup of coffee as well? It's a green room under you too.
It's another one. That's amazing. Hi.
Hi. I just have a quick question. So they immortalized you in this video game, which you probably had some say. Was there any aspect?
They what? Did they do?
Immortalized us.
Yes.
I like
was
that.
Oh.
I'm going to have to use that more. I was immortalized in the game Assassin's Creed.
Why did it
Creed.
Sound weird when you said
Hi, Paul. How are you? Yeah, I'm good. How are you feeling? Well, I'm feeling good. I was immortalized.
It sounds like something happened to you. Really traumatic. Yeah, I had a good weekend. I was immortalized.
Yeah.
I was just wondering if there's any aspect of the character that they took your features that you absolutely loved and they nailed it, or that you hated. since now they're...
Well, I hope they didn't take our features because they owe me more money.
Oh, no, they did. It was 79.9.9999999999 because when it gets to 80%, they have to pay you. Which is not a lie, actually. It's cool. It's rendering likenesses and they keep the likeness. There's a percentage of how your what your likeness is. Do you know this? So when they render your information on your facial structure, there's a percentage of how much it looks like you. So what they do is they keep it just under the legal percentage so that they don't have to pay you for anything. And often the concept art is very different to the game because they don't want to pay you for the advertising. Did you discuss this with your manager? Probably was wise. No? Anyway.
So there is nothing that you hated about?
It's weird because I play that game and I've seen the sequences and I can actually see myself in it, right?
Jacob can grow a better beard though.
Well, I can't grow a beard, so I just got this poncy thing on the end of my chin.
I like Evie's freckles. I don't have any freckles.
Yeah.
So they're cool. And she has a different shape face to me. I think hers is rounder than mine. And she has a nice plait in her hair, which I like, which I've never done.
Jacob looks a bit like Hugh Jackman at times.
Yeah, Jacob's better looking than you.
Nothing like Hugh Jackman. Okay. Anyway, there you go.
Thank you. Oh yeah, you could raise that back up.
Or just hoodie down.
Or take it off just and hold it.
It'll look like you're taking a shit, but... It's just not the best way to ask a question. Just wanna... Hi.
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 I just wanted to know, how do you guys feel doing or working on the Jack the Ripper DLC for Assassin's Creed Syndicate?
How did you feel about that, Paul?
That was my lowest point in the whole series of working on Assassin's Creed was working on that DLC. It was a disaster.
Why? Because
I wasn't in it.
Because he couldn't be narcissistic in that. Because there was no opportunity for it.
No, I don't know. Am I allowed to say? I guess Jacob had a way different ending in that one, and I kind of had to fight for it a bit. So in the end, he just had like the pirate eye patch. But yeah, you loved it, right? You loved.
I thought it was a nice chance for to see the Assassin's Creed universe bring a playable female for her own game. Even if it was just the DLC, I think it was a spark for things to come. And I really enjoyed doing it. I thought it was nice to have the history of Jack the Ripper, and to be able to, you know, as an actress, lead the game a little bit.
Another fun fact. The guy who voices Jack the Ripper is a guy who I was in National Youth Theatre of Great Britain with for 2 years, a guy called Alec Newman.
We never met him doing that, though.
No, we never met him, but I actually know Alec quite well. I knew him quite well. We did Othello together with Chiwetel Ejiofor and Orlando Bloom.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Well, there's some fun facts for you.
Fun fact of the day.
It was good.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Did you play it, the DLC?
I haven't yet.
What?
You watched the whole thing.
Yeah. Okay, got you.
Okay. Yeah. Hey. Cool cosplay.
Thank you.
Which one are you again, Connor?
Yeah.
Yeah. That's the one that people don't really like that much, right?
This is one of my favorites.
I know you're doing an amazing job, right? We love all the assassins. I joke.
So you guys wore the outfits and saw them. So what's your favorite part of it? Like the whole outfit of Evie and Jacob?
Oh, that's a good question.
I actually had a little input into the into Evie's costume and the final thing that happened. The pocket watch wasn't on there before. And I said, you know, after researching the character before we started, I said, well, this lady, you know, she's planning things, she's very organized. How does she do it? How does she get Jacob on time to things? How do they, you know, how
do we get Victoria on time to things?
Yeah. Well, I didn't
maybe
get
you need
a watch
one in real life as well.
I knew you were just going to be blabbing along at the start. It just saved me a little bit of energy. So the pocket watch was actually my idea, and then they were really helpful and you know, very open to my suggestions, and so I liked that she has that.
Yeah.
So that was my input into her character.
Yeah, it was one of the only ideas she really had.
And Jacob was none of your ideas.
No, Jacob was... there were lots of things that were my ideas. I don't know where to start.
What?
On his outfit?
Oh, well, if we're talking about rehearsing.
No, his outfit, that's the question. His outfit.
Oh, the outfit.
But no, you had no
Let's go on to other things.
He had no input. That's the answer.
I thought it was super cool. I thought they did an amazing job with the outfits. And the watching people cosplay them is really, really great. But apparently they're really difficult to cosplay if you're a true cosplayer where you make it from scratch. Because there's so much leather involved. It's like, it's really detailed work, and then you've got the paisley, and it's a lot of, it's not easy. But the people that we've seen do them, the best ones were the Russian girls, right? Remember the Russian girl? She was like phenomenal, right? And the ones I have seen that are top grade are incredible. So, I mean, I love the trench coat. And I thought the trench coat's what we used when we were rehearsing. When I said that we got like a mock-up, it wasn't like the full costume. Because usually like when you do motion capture, you're basically in a leotard. And you wear sneakers.
And you've got little dots and balls.
And you've got little dots and balls all over your face, and you've got this heavy camera. It could
be so balls all over your face.
It could be further away from an assassin, right? And you've got to work every day like you're running, like you're going for a morning jog. In like a ballet costume, hardly assassin. So what we decided to do is that we had special boots rigged. So I actually wore fry boots, and we rigged them with the balls, and then we basically got a costume when we were doing rehearsing that was really weighty and heavy, and they had it commissioned for us. It cost like $1,000, and then we would wear those in rehearsal, and then it just gave you a physical sense of what it was to be in London. It was rainy, it was heavy leather, you know, you just did to keep that stance. So we did a lot of that stuff. We are real actors at the end of the day, as much as I joke around and it sounds like I don't take anything in life seriously. We did take our job fairly seriously.
I think those coats are now at the Ubisoft offices in glass boxes, apparently. That's what was going to happen with them.
Oh.
I don't know if that actually happened.
I just thought Jeff Skalski, the producer, just runs around in his house in them.
Maybe.
Or maybe the Evie one only.
Maybe. Great question, thank you.
Thank you.
Hello
again.
Hey.
I had two questions, one for both of you and then one for Paul, if that's real quick.
Okay.
Go for
it. My first question is, if you could pick a setting for the next Assassin's Creed game that you would be in, which would it be?
Did you ask the one about, who said the, oh no, that other guy. I liked the idea of the Wild West. I think that era is really super cool. It's just full of assassins, right? The Wild West. But it'd be tricky to bring in the Hidden Blade, but Hidden Blades and revolver and guns could be fun. And horses and, you know, yeah.
That'd be cool.
Yeah, we've already done horses, so there could be an extension of that then.
Yeah, Indians. It's not really quite the same on camels or anything.
Yeah, who would be the Templars in the Wild West?
Be like Indian.
Maybe you'd be an Indian.
Yeah.
Maybe the assassin is an Indian.
The what? Train owners?
Yeah, the train owners.
Or like the Gold Rush.
Yeah, the Gold Rush
like
people, yeah.
I would like it, I've been saying that I would like Evie and Henry to have one in India. And like go forward in time and see them with their kids in India as mini assassins.
Oh, Jesus, it's like time, Days of Our Life, man. It's like a soap opera.
It would be fun. I like
Henry
it.
And Vic, yeah.
No, it's Evie.
It's Evie. I know. So Victoria Fry.
And then my question for Paul. I was really happy when the writers came out and said that Jacob was bisexual, and that meant a lot to me as a person. And I was wondering, since Jacob doesn't really have a love interest in a Syndicate, what would be his perfect love interest?
Well, I don't know, because, I mean, they established that he has a daughter, right? In the future, because his granddaughter is in the sequence.
Yeah.
So it's obviously a very strong woman, somebody who could put up with Jacob and keep him in check, much like my own wife, really.
I don't know how she does it. I'd rather be in prison.
So yeah, maybe it would be the woman I married to. Jeez, am I Jacob?
Yeah. Well, doesn't Jacob also have a little crush on Pearl Attaway?
He likes the older women.
Yeah, he likes a sugar mama.
Yeah,
that's probably what
I think that
with.
That's another like mother replay, because they lost their mum when they were young, right? So with Pearl, I think it's more like it's motherly instinct that he's that relationship is about. which also often gets confused as well with the Oedipus complex. So, you know, you can often fall in love with your mum. Did I just say that?
Yeah, and it's on tape.
Oh.
I'm
prepared
to
wife
to your mother yesterday on Friday, so.
Yeah, you could.
Gee whiz, I need therapy right now. Like, yeah. Right this instant. Yeah, is there a therapist in the room? We could go under here because apparently it's a green room.
Go in the lost and found room. Yeah. And you can find yourself.
The password is edible.
Thank you.
Hey.
Wow.
Chainsaw man. What is that?
Oh, it's a chainsaw hand from Evil Dead. I'm Ash Williams. So I came in late, so I don't know if anyone else asked this question, but
so did I.
What was more important than us?
No.
Well, where were you? Who were you seeing?
Yeah, where were you?
Who was signing your things?
No, you've got to answer us. You're not getting away with it.
Besides Syndicate.
Excuse me, please answer the question.
Signatures from the...
From who?
The actors and actresses.
Which one?
Sister Location.
Oh!
Sister Location? Who's that?
Five Nights at Freddy's game.
I haven't, yeah.
Oh.
Have you ever seen that game? It's bizarre.
Anyway, as I was about to ask, besides Syndicate, which of the Assassin's Creed games would be your favorite, besides Syndicate?
I suppose Black Flag. Yeah.
Was that the only one you played?
No, I played some Unity, because I like fun.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, I actually didn't think Unity was as bad as everyone said.
I didn't like Unity at all.
But...
Don't you mean Assassin's Creed and the Glitch Kingdom?
Yeah, no, it was more the concept that I found difficult with Unity. It was just, I mean, it was French Revolution. You had all these British people running around. I was just, I think they should have gone a little further into really establishing that world a little bit better than they did.
What did you like, though?
Well, what did I like? The Ezio trilogy is tough to compete with, right? Because it's what made the franchise.
Yeah.
And it was Roger did a really, really great job with that as a voice actor. I mean, he didn't do any motion capture like we did, but it was because, you know.
But he still
he
loved,
was just in a booth.
He still loved more.
But
than
he
us.
Still loved more than us.
We get a little sad about that.
Like, oh, what's your favorite assassin?
No, the best is, you're my favorite assassin apart from Ezio.
Apart from Ezio. Yeah, Syndicate's up there. That's right, yeah.
Just under Ezio.
Which is understandable, right? You know, it was a cool period, you know. So, yeah, I mean, that trilogy? Probably the trilogy itself, because it's complete, right? So, yeah.
Well, before I go, speaking of Assassin's Creed 3, I know you weren't talking about the exact one, but still.
Yeah.
Altair is most hated more than Connor, just so you know.
Altair
oh, really?
Is?
Oh, we'll tell that to Cass and Vol.
We know Cass. I'll text him now.
Yeah, let's text him. Hey, Luma, can you make sure Cass sees this? Altair is the most hated assassin. And then Connor.
Then Jacob. Jacob. Go on. Hi. Oh, you were dressed as Evie, weren't you, earlier?
Yeah.
Fight Club Evie.
The rain kind of dampened it.
That's okay. You looked awesome earlier.
Thank you.
Still look awesome, but you were Evie earlier.
Thank you.
What's your question?
I just wanted to ask, if Jacob and Evie sparred in the Fight Club, who do you think would win?
Oh.
Oh, I just realized a child walked out. Sorry about the swearing. You should put a swear jar on that.
You can put it. You can do the swear jar, and I'll take the I'll take the money.
Any money I earned this weekend would all go in. What's the question? I'm just in a world of my own.
Sorry,
general.
I
need therapy.
Right? This is the question, and now I forgot.
Yeah.
If Jacob and Evie fought in the fight club.
I don't know if we could fight each other. That's, I don't know, I don't like that. I don't like him beating me up.
Depends how many pints Jacob's had.
I don't think he would hit Evie.
Oh, I don't know.
Okay.
It's friendly sparring.
Yeah, it should be a bit
friendly
annoying.
Sparring, like just the punch.
Brothers and sisters fight, right?
Well, who do we think would win? Well, we've had...
Brothers and sisters fight, right?
Yeah, I suppose so.
I mean, my brother used to...
Yeah,
used
but
to
brother and brother...
fight my sister, and I used to then beat the shit out of him.
It was like when we just kept doing it, right? You're bouncing back and forth.
I don't know. Don't who do you think would win?
Jacob, clearly.
No.
But she would get it back when he passed out.
She'd probably shave his eyebrows off
or shave his mutton chops off. And he's like, oh no, I look
Yeah, she might not
now.
Win at the time, but just like longevity, she would win. Like, or there'll be just little things over time that would
Who would
add
you put
up.
Your money on?
Huh?
How many people would put their money on Evie? How many people put their money on Jacob? It's hard to see. I don't need to go any further with this one. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Hi.
Hi, Anna.
I had a question for both of you. Is there a showrunner or a writer or an actor that you've worked with previously that you'd love to work with again?
Cool.
Because, Paul, I know some fans want to see you on Wynonna Earp to work with Emily Andrus again, who...
Emily would just like write me in. Yeah.
I know, of course.
and the character was fun. Yeah, I love that period too. Like they do a really super cool period. I would like to work with I'd like to work with Ksenia again, who I work with on Lost Girl, who's in Orphan Black and on Turn and loads of other stuff. She's like one of my favorite people and an incredible actress. It's like dynamic working with her. So, yeah, doing like a cool little movie with her, or actually a lot of the people I work with in Moscow, they were really super cool. Not really any of the people I work with on Syndicate. Can't really think of any that.
I can't even bother to comment back.
Somebody from Hollyoaks?
I don't know, some people are doing very well from there now. Who want to work with it? To be honest, I really love working with new people, you know, and working with new actors and seeing the guys that I'm working with now on this new show are all new people that I've never worked with before, and they're very complimentary as actors and very generous, and we get to play a lot. So I'm excited to see how that turns out, you know, and working with them. So I said the other day I would love to be part of Westworld. I'd love to get on that show and play as a robot, Western robot. I think that would be really fun for me.
I think you could do that really well.
Thanks, Paul. I know that wasn't a genuine compliment. Thanks.
Robot.
What characters did you use as inspiration for how you portrayed Jacob and Evie?
Well, that's a good one. Definitely Lara Croft was an influence for me. And a lot of Jessica Jones kind of, but that was many before. But the Victorian period itself, I like to do research on the history, so it was just different characters from that. And then we actually got to meet them, like Florence Nightingale and all those people. I kind of looked at how people were acting in those days and real people, and then how would their job be an assassin. So, yeah, but Lara Croft was a big influence.
Yeah, I mean, I didn't really do a lot of research in that sense. I mean, no one really knows what people were like in that time, right? We don't really know how they were speaking or what the language was like. I just created something, you know, the cool that made sense. I mean, if anything, I mean, I just come off doing a show, there was still remnants of a character that I was just playing, which is, you know, it's tough when you do a show, when you do a show for a long time on TV, it's like when you do it, it's not like doing movies where you can go in and you do it and then you get out. Those characters can disappear quite quickly, but when you're on a show for like 5-6 years, they stick around for a while. So there were definitely elements of a character that I was playing on Lost Girl in the role that I was doing. It was just shaped and molded in a slightly different way. Because it's hard to let them go. That's why, sometimes it takes people a while after they get off on a long running series to go and create something new again.
Yeah. That's his excuse at the moment.
Yeah, or I'm just a shit actor and that's all I got. That's all I got, everyone. That's all you're going to get from me from now on in until the end of my career.
Vex and Jacob.
Vex and Jacob.
In different forms. In different costumes.
Yeah.
Thank you. Hey.
Hey, nice seeing you again.
Good to see you.
So I know Victoria already sort of answered this, but I just want to ask it again.
if you could work on like any show, like I don't know, like a dream job, like Walking Dead, Sherlock, Game of Thrones, something like that, what show would you want to work on and why?
I would have wanted to have worked on The Wire when The Wire was on. I was a big, big fan of that show. Really great writing. Actually, anything that that Simon puts out, I would want to be a part of. It's just great writing, great shows. Yeah, and also Terrence Winter as well. I love The Sopranos.
Like just, Sopranos is fantastic.
Just excellent, excellent shows with great, great characters. You know, borderline theatrical, but real. You know, the sort of characters I love to play. You know, the ones that are real borderline. Like, they may be close to being over the top, but not.
Yeah, and like I said, Westworld would be good, but I like, I would like to do a historical period movie. I would love to play Emily Bronte in a film. I think that would be good, about the Bronte sisters. Or I would like to, Gillian Anderson does so many cool roles, like her role in X-Files, and I like the stuff that she's been doing lately, so. Something along those lines. Thanks.
Thank you.
All right, last two questions.
All right, so I totally have a question.
You've been working with us all weekend. Why didn't you just ask us? You sat next to us at the table. Why didn't you just ask me this question?
It's for everyone.
She wants a t-shirt.
Not for me, because it's a small, but...
She wants it running for the t-shirt.
Right, okay.
Go on, give us your best question.
If they were to make a movie or TV show based off Syndicate, would you want to reprise your roles?
Of course. Of course. I wouldn't want anybody else to play you.
Yeah, I don't think anyone else. It'd be weird, wouldn't it, for the fans if somebody else played those characters. I mean, it's not like, you know, if it was the movie version, then it'd be different, right? Because then they get into completely different realms. But I think in like a TV series or like an animation or even a TV series.
But I think because we did do the facial capture and the motion capture, all the expressions and all the body movements of them are us.
It's us.
You know, so we carved that performance and those characters as we would any TV or film job.
Yeah.
And they just, in this case, were animated rather than live action.
Yeah, a lot of those tricks and shit you use as an actor, you know, they're all ours, right? They're both, you know, Victoria and myself. So it'd be a completely different thing, right? But, I mean, that happens a lot. So, I mean, the US does different versions of the British stuff all the time. So, yeah. But I would love to.
I think you guys would be awesome.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Be fun.
Hi.
How do you guys like your eggs in the morning?
How we like our eggs?
We had to get one anime question in by the end of this, didn't we? We had to have one person ask us.
I do like this question.
Really? I love this question.
This is great.
I'm just pointing out, we had to have one, didn't we?
We
could not get away.
And it's the last one.
Yeah, and you were like, no, there's no way we're going out of this one without having one of those anime questions.
Well, this is a good question for the podcast, whatever Loomer's doing as well.
This is a tough question.
Oh, it's not tough for me. If someone was going to make me eggs in the morning, I know exactly what I'd want.
Do you know there's 404 uses for eggs?
No.
Yeah, there is.
Well, I know exactly how I like them.
Thank you.
Unless there's going to be some new thing.
We got each other, right?
We do.
We got each other on the
404
egg.
Uses, but do you know those? No, let's not do that.
I could go through them, actually.
No, let's please. I want to get out of here.
Yeah, because it's a binder, right? It's like the egg white's a binding property. There's a lot of fat in the yolk, so yeah.
I would have poached eggs.
Why you gotta get the eggs that are like the hardest to make?
Because I need somebody that's gonna make good eggs for me.
Do you know what I like?
For life.
A 63 degree egg. That's what I mean. And you think I'm taking the piss, but I'm not. I actually have a sous vide machine, and I do my 63 eggs because I cook a lot of ramen and from scratch. And 63 eggs are the best eggs. And actually, let me just say, if you've actually got a brunch or anything like that, it's brilliant. You do them the day before, you do all eggs 63 degrees, you put them in the fridge, and then frying them only takes about 20 seconds. So if you have a lot of people to do lunch for or brunch for, you just crack them open and they're almost already done, and then you just do the ends of them and it takes like 20 seconds. So you can actually serve a lot of people very quickly.
There you go.
And not only that, the unctuous egg yolk is delicious. Was that too much?
Is that you? Are we done?
No, eggs could have like such a complicated answer.
I'd have poached eggs with hollandaise sauce and some salmon.
Yeah,
it'd be lovely. And a little bit of spinach on the side. That's exactly how I would love my eggs in the morning.
And now I want eggs.
Thank you.
Great,
thank
thanks.
Way to go, Taylor.
All right, we've got one last one. He's
one last one, really? And then we're going to decide who's the best question for this.
He's probably the best one. He's been waiting, right?
Come on.
Oh, I have two questions.
One question. Whoa. What made you think you could ask two?
Because he's wearing sunglasses. He can ask as many as he wants.
One question.
Okay,
ask
one question, and then we're going to decide who wins this. Go.
Would you work with Handsome Jack and David Eddings?
Who?
Damian Clark and David Eddings. It's Claptrap and Handsome Jack from Borderlands.
Have you met them?
David gave me a signed pop figure today.
Yeah.
Oh, those guys.
Yeah. Would you work with them?
What, they just own a video game?
Would I work with them?
Wait, is this a question? Would I work with them?
Yeah. Are we getting paid? Yeah.
No. Well, one last question.
He's really going for the second question. His first question was shit.
What do you guys drive?
You better be better.
What do we drive?
What do we drive?
Should we make it up? I drive a Ferrari.
I drive a Tesla.
That's it. That's our questions. Right, who's going to win this? No, we need to decide.
And then it's conflict.
They must deliberate, make sure that they remember all the questions.
Okay, no, that person was really shit.
No, that made
one,
you...
That's one of the worst questions I've ever
had. That made you life. Answer a really long question.
She was quite sexy, though.
Who was that?
Who was that?
Which one?
And I know you really fancy it, but no, we can't give it to him.
Okay, alright. He was hot, though.
He was hot.
Is he single?
I don't know, ask him. Maybe when you give him the t-shirt, put your number on the back.
Okay.
Put your hotel room number.
I'm not in my hotel room anymore, I just checked out.
Was it 10:21?
10:51, but I checked out.
Oh god. I checked back in. Just for the night.
Can't because I don't think the convention will cover it for another night.
Oh, but you made some money this weekend. Put it down, it's free. I mean, you used to pay for it, right?
So I'll just put my email address.
Okay.
Okay, so we're going to give the prize for the best question today to our friend that asked about the roast dinners. So come on down. This is yours. Woo!
Here we go. Here's your white t-shirt from us. What's your name again? Daniel, congratulations.
Thanks
for a good question.
It's
made me think about my mum's roast dinner.
All right, thanks. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you, everyone. You guys are great. Oh, and we're in Albuquerque next weekend. If you know any friends that didn't get to this one, they want to see us.
Thank you.